r/askreddit. What NSFW thing have you seen in public that you will never forget? When I was 15, I was at a lodger's family reunion on a large plot of private property. Me, my uncle, my cousin and my dad's cousin were all at the edge of the property overlooking a river. We saw a canoe coming down the river. When they got close, we saw a guy and a girl in the canoe. All of a sudden, the guy yells, "Grab a net." My cousin replies, "Why?" The man proceeded to respond, "Because you're about to catch some titty," and the girl proceeded to flash us. It was great. I'll never forget it. Such kind strangers. Edit, thanks for the titty. Kind strangers. A gentleman that my coworkers and I have dubbed Naked Yoga Man. We work in an office next to an apartment building, and if you're on the early shift on the fourth floor, you can witness a middle-aged man doing yoga on his balcony entirely naked. Every morning. Without fail. Someone complained once, and he put on tiny gold booty shorts for about a week, before deciding they were cramping his style. Edit, holy it. My top comment ever is about Naked Yoga Man. I have to thank him or something. And nobody is hit on the country yet, Australia. Actually, but I'm glad there are Naked Yoga Men all around the world, to provide as many people as possible with that particular brand of joy. I don't know, I think this is pretty great. It's ducking amazing. Once when I was at an outdoor swimming pool in my tweens, we were in a mixed group playing with big inflatable tires in the water close to me. One of the girls climbed on top near me, and her bikini bottom got briefly stuck on the valve, giving me a brief full flash of her pussy. The image was burned in my mind. And years of masturbating to the image has not diminished the hotness of the situation. Come gather. Ye children, ye darlings of youth. I'll spin you a story of passion and truth. I'll tell you a tale of delights and desires. Of vulvas and valves, and of titties and tires. The children were gathered. They listened. Beguiled. He told them his story. And wistfully smiled. And oh. He concluded, "I still see it yet. That day in the pool, that I'll never forget. Carrot 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 tth tth. How much would you charge to follow me around on my birthday and narrate my life with poems?" A dude going down on a chick in a booth at a Red Lobster. I was on my way to the bathroom and made awkward eye contact with the chick. All you can eat crab feast. Got him. Once, on a dark night, while many drunk idiots were stumbling home through the center of town, I walked past a man urinating in a side alley, pants around his knees. Tattooed over his entire ass was the moon from Majora's Mask. I have never known fear like that since. It seems you've been met with a terrible fate. Haven't you? Ducked you crazy mask seller guy. On the commute into London, I sat opposite a man and a woman who were obviously a couple. The woman kept acting slightly fidgety and making muffled yelps every now and then. I kept glancing over out of the corner of my eye. And it wasn't until we were halfway through the journey that I saw what the man had in his hand, one of those small, pink, remote control devices that I guess paired with whatever vibrating X toy the woman had down her drawers. Didn't actually get to see anything directly, I guess. Though she had trouble standing up to get off the train at the final station. That sounds hot. Doubtful. The weather in London is pretty dismal for most of the year. At a music festival, I saw a guy, obviously on way too many drugs, jacking off to an art installation full of tiny psychedelic dolls whilst being held in a chokehold by a security guard. He didn't stop and came all over the ground before more security dragged him away. Crap, didn't realize you guys would react to that so much, but here's a little extra for you. The installation was a glass shed smaller than a garden shed, and my sister was one side and I could see the guy being held on the other. My lovable idiot sister, however, didn't see what was happening, so she basically had her face pressed against the glass directly opposite him. I started yelling at her to get away from it, and as soon as she turned around, that's when the dude came. I had to go drown myself in Captain Morgan after to try and forget, but alas. Splendor in the grass always knows how to put on a show. So, performance art then? No. It's only performance art if it gets funding. Seriously, as far as I've been able to discern, this is the defining criteria. Edit, blimey. It appears my comment was a controversial and challenging piece. I can probably work in some nudity if anyone's got money. Edit, gilded. It. I'm not getting my tackle out for you mucky buggers. I've got a BSC. Saw a girl blowing a guy in a car. Saw an obese woman hold her fattest 3-year-old on the bus. Take off his pants. Put his feet on the seat in front of him. And then had him hit onto a shopping bag on the floor. She left the bag. What the duck? IKR. If he was driving at the time. That's hella dangerous. When I was about 10 or 11. Pulling into a 3-star hotel with my family. There was a couple just ducking hardcore on a random bench across the parking lot. Come to think of it. That was probably when I first became interested in the idea of X. Think of it this way. You would have never been interested in X were it not for the couple. You owe your exuality to them. Thanks, mystery duckers. That one drunk ripped Irish dude that was running on a small ledge at 7 in the morning, completely ducking naked. Hooker lured him back inside while waving his wallet. I honestly thought I'd see a man die that day because the ledge was so narrow and he was sprinting over it like nothing. Edit, yes. It was Conor McGregor. The Irish have magic feet. They can't fall if they're drunk. Weebles wobble but they don't fall down. Edit, really? This is my highest voted comment? Yeah, la, just too much. Once a 20-something woman came into my store to shop wearing a tank top and a small jacket. Noticed as she walked by that her whole tit was out on one side. No kid in sight. So I'm assuming it was accidental. No clue how she didn't notice. Had nice tits though. Working retail. You see some strange and sometimes wondrous things. Chances are is that she knew that her tit was out. And probably was doing it for attention or the lulz. I work in a high-end men/women's clothing store. And from this, I have learned that some people have absolutely no shame or probably just assume that I'm gay because I work in a high-end fashion clothing store and am male. But I've definitely had both men and women strip in front of me to try things on. I cannot tell you the discipline needed to maintain full eye contact while a gorgeous 20, 30-something woman is standing bare-breasted in front of you asking you about clothing. There've been a few times that I've walked into the back after they've left and jerked it. Not going to lie. Waiting for them to leave before you jerk it is a true mark of a professional. Some old dude wanking it while riding a bike. Wanking it while riding a bike. This requires some skill though. Not if you have one of the bikes where you're pretty much lying down while riding it. I saw a homeless man taking a water bottle shower in a subway terminal. He cleaned everywhere. Everywhere. Stupid XE Flanders. Living in London. Neighbor's kid having a party when the neighbors were away. Some of the youths decided to duck. There were clearly not enough rooms in the house, so they did it in the back garden. My bedroom window overlooked our back gardens. Working in a call center, saw a girl give a BJ to a guy in the courtyard behind the office. I would have held up a stopwatch to the young kids and just yelled out 1 minute 30 mate. Not good enough, sir. We have absolutely no desire to beat your 10 seconds record. Movie theater. Entering a movie that had been out in the cinemas for about a month already. Walking into the theater to find a very young blonde girl giving a blowjob to her man friend. Best part was they weren't even sitting far back at all, and the guy didn't notice us until it was too late. Edit, I don't use Reddit that often so I'm sorry. This was Gold Coast, Australia about 5 years ago. That sounded kinda ominous. What did you do to them? It was too late. A man standing on his balcony scrubbing his penis with a wire brush. WTF. Why would anyone do such a thing? I've done some regrettable things in my time. Put my little fella into some regrettable places. But for the life of me, I cannot figure out how he got his todger so filthy it needed a wire brush cleaning. Saw someone eating a Kit Kat in one big bite instead of breaking them apart and eating it individually. Made me feel ducking sick. Thank you for sharing. You're very, very brave for doing this. I can't thank you all enough for the support. I was actually trembling reading that. I got up to go for a break and to simply breathe. And all I could picture was the collective single crunch of the Kit Kat. Madness. Pure madness. I'm in therapy. You know. It doesn't help. Nothing helps. I was doing a 3-point turn in a narrow road which actually took about 7 points. pulled into a gap between two parked cars, only to be facing a woman taking a piss. Panties down, hitching up her shirt to avoid splash. I was trying to get the hell out of there as quickly as possible, but she just kept yelling at me, like I was the one in the wrong. Oh duck. I was sitting outside of a bar once waiting for my ride. And this hot chick across the street, pulled her pants down, and started pissing behind a 2-foot-high electrical box in full view of me. She casually struck up a conversation with me, asking me how my night was, who I was waiting for, who I was with, etc. She didn't even bother to pull her pants up before she got up. She stood up fully, bent over, and pulled them up. One of the stranger events in my life for sure. I was staying at my friend's flat. They lived in a district where, well, whole neighborhood was NSFW. We were having a dinner, and I heard some noise behind the door. They warned me not to look. But I did. I saw a fat guy, pants down, and a really ugly old hooker on her knees, blowing him, his tiny fat Ike, and her ugly skinny skeleton-like wrinkled face, and a dirty old t-shirt she was wearing. Christ. I will never unsee this. How was the whole neighborhood NSFW? Untethered ladders everywhere. Make sure to like and subscribe so we can watch together.